It took a while, but we are now live from Segra Field in Leesburg, Virginia. Washington Spirit, Portland Thorns doing battle on a Wednesday night. Thank you for joining us alongside Gary Bailey, Brandon Ross here with you. As we're set to get going, a big change made to the lineup for Portland. As we were getting ready to come on the air, finding out Sophia Smith, originally listed in the starting 11, is now out. Marissa Everett taking her spot.
This is massive. This is one of the great players of the moment, Sophia Smith. And the fact that she is not available means Washington Spirit have a great chance to get the 3 points they so desperately need tonight.
It took a little extra time to get us going. Rain and lightning in the area, but the whistle has been blown, and we are finally underway from Segra Field. The full starting 11 for Portland: Becky Sauerbrunn, Hina Sugita, with the absence of Smith, Marissa Everett, Rocky Rodriguez, Christine Sinclair, Natalia Cuica, Sam Coffey, Kelly Hubley, Yasmin Ryan, Megan Klingenberg in front of Bella Bixby. They center it up for Sinclair. Working out left. Ryan dances to the middle, fires away, it's off a back, and it's cleared out.
Well, let's just make this point very clear that even though they don't have Sophia Smith, this Portland side is a fantastic outfit with so many class players. Of course, you've still got the wonderful Christine Sinclair pulling the strings from that slightly deeper attacking midfield role. Rocky Rodriguez, Sugita's got 4 goals. Yasmin Ryan. So by no stretch of the imagination is this an easy match for Washington Spirit, but you take away Sophia Smith and you look at what they have going forward, Washington Spirit, suddenly it becomes a really doable game. 3 points up for grabs.
Washington still without a win since the season opener. In front of Aubrey Kingsbury, send out Trinity Rodman, Sam Staub, Kelly O'Hara, Tara Micchione, Ashley Sanchez, Andy Sullivan, Dorian Bailey, Amber Brooks, Cameron Bogelski, and Ashley Hatch. Coffey works it back. A little too long for Ryan down that left side.
Just to give you a sense of the changes from the previous outing, Washington side that drew 1-1 at Louisville. Bogelski, as you mentioned, coming in, and a Helferty goes to the bench, Terry McKeown in, Jordan Baggett to the bench. So two changes there, four for Portland from the team that drew 3-3 against Courage. Megan Nally, Tegan McGrady, Morgan Weaver, and as we've just found out, Sophia Smith go to the bench. Cuica, Klingenberg, Ryan, and Everett coming in.
It's a Portland side sitting atop the table. Nearing the home stretch of this 2022 regular season, can they cling on to the top? A lot of teams waiting to take their spot. Washington a ways back. We can put a dent in their record tonight. O'Hara. 10-year NWSL vet set to throw. Can't enter it through. This one, well over-launched.
You know what's interesting for me about this matchup, even though Washington Spirit are the reigning champions, they're sitting right near the bottom of the table, they have the worst points per game out of the entire NWSL up against Portland, who, not surprisingly, have the best points per game. So it really is a tricky, risky play at the back there, Bella Bixby. But it's a contrast of two teams in absolutely opposing forms, and yet both have great players.
Bailey fans on that attempt with the left foot, and this has been a dangerous push here for Washington.
Taking a few risks at the back, but just to finish my point, as Spirit, I tell you what, Spirit are piling in. You get the sense they know they have to win this one, but both teams are loaded with great players, but one sits top of the table, Portland Thorns, the other. If they do not win tonight, Washington Spirit, the chances are extremely slim that they even make the playoffs. And to say again, they are the current reigning champions.
Quite a slide here in 2022 for the home side in this contest, but playing with energy out the gate after an initial push from Portland. The Thorns struggling to get out of their own end. Center for Sinclair. Throws it downfield right at O'Hara. Aubrey Kingsbury averaging 1 1/3 goals allowed per contest. Only a pair of clean sheets as Washington has found itself on the back end of a ton of games, but typically ending up even. Of the 15 games in the books, 9 draws, 5 losses, the only win coming back in the season opener against OL Reign.
This is a team, I think, went something like 20 games without losing. I've very rarely have I ever seen a team go from such a good winning run to such a bad losing run. And it's inexplicable. You ask Chris Ward, he's at a loss for a reason for it. It's just a whole bunch of things, perhaps a couple of results not going your way. A lot of draws, as you quite rightly suggest, that maybe should have been wins.
Sinclair trying to dodge trouble, gets that back to Bixby. But again, the talent's still there. You still have Trinity Rodman on that Washington side. Ashley Sanchez provides a lot of spark. Ashley Hatch, of course, as well, but it hasn't materialized into results. Time running low to make something happen this season. They feel the pressure. Bigelski against Sugita. Enter and a good touch off. Hatch can't reach it, but stays with Washington. Rodman to O'Hara. Lofts it down. Header. Can't find the initial target. A late touch. But Bixby gets to it.
Well, that swing from Ashley Hatch more or less sums up Washington's season ever since the Challenge Cup final when they were on a tear. And since then, was it 16 games? They haven't won in normal time. Bella Bixby with a bit of a graze on the side of her leg. Just covers that one up. But that fell straight for Ashley Hatch and she totally whiffed on the ball, and you're thinking there's a quality player, top goal scorer from last season, and here she is unable to connect with the ball. Now, of course, there's still plenty of minutes to go in this game, but there's something just not clicking for Washington's spirit, and it must be driving coach Chris Ward absolutely mad.
Starting off aggressive, a lot of players playing up high, but if they overcommit, they could obviously get beat. Coffee ricochets to Klingenberg. They keep possession with the visitors.
There he is, Chris Ward. Looks relaxed in the t-shirt, but I think underneath it all, you must be wondering how you can go from being champions and reaching the Challenge Cup final on that unbeaten 20-odd run spell to where he is now. And again, just to say that they have 7 games left, Washington Spirit. I think they have to win 6 of them to get to at least 5. But probably they're going to have to win 6, given that everybody else will pick up points, just to make the playoffs.
And not to mention the teams below them in the table, Gotham and North Carolina, much fewer games played. Courage are only halfway through their schedule. This one goes high and long. Ryan able to trace it down. Enters. Centers. That chip well high from Coffee.
I think if you're Aubrey Kingsbury, any of those players, the moment they heard Sophia Smith, 11 goals in 11 games, who for me it's right now one of the best players in the world. Her pace, her ability to finish. She's been scoring goals in the last 5 games. She scored in every one. She scored a couple in some of them. It's an incredible sort of run of form she's on. I can only assume she picked up an injury in the warm-ups, but with her not playing, you've got to see the locker room vibe change if you're Washington Spirit. Suddenly there's real belief that, hey, maybe we've got some luck at last.
Smith entering tonight tied with Alex Morgan in the race for the Golden Boot at 11 goals. Still plenty of time to decide the victor of this year's crown. Rodriguez loses the handle. Back for Klingenberg. Crosses it down. We'll go back to Washington as the flag comes up.
I guess it's not just Washington's incredibly bad form, an inexplainable form. It's how good Portland are. No losses in the last 10, 5 of those wins. Top scorers in the league with 34. I mean, they've put 6 goals in past Houston Dash, I think it was, 5 past Orlando Pride. They drew 3-3 in their last match, which is very rare for them to concede three. But again, they're able to score goals from so many different sources. And I think that's going to be the hard job for Washington Spirit tonight. If they can keep a clean sheet, and obviously with the firepower they have with the Rodmans and Sanchez's and Hatch, every chance they can come away with 3 points. But keeping the clean sheet is the key here.
Rodman fended off the ball and then commits the foul against Sinclair. If you're Portland, who are you looking to? With Sophia Smith not in the picture.
It's got to be Christine Sinclair. A wonderful, wonderful player. And she might not last the full 90 minutes, but if the coach, Rian Wilkinson, gets 60 good minutes out of the Canadian international, who scored 64 times in 175 matches for Portland Thorns. So she knows how to score. There she is on the ball right now.
Also keep an eye on Hina Sugita. Good run these last few games. Rian Wilkinson highlighting that not only very technical, but willing to do the things most players aren't eager to do on the pitch, off the ball. The aforementioned rolls it back, and Sauerbrunn will get this run started.
What's also interesting about the schedule coming up is that after this match, Washington gets 17 days without a game. Other teams are playing in the NWSL. There's also two tournaments taking place. You think, well, hang on a second. If they get 3 points here, they get a really good rest and a time to, you know, regather energy. They could make a massive push towards the end of the season while their competitors are playing extra fixtures and maybe get the odd injury and some tired legs. So, again, 3 points, an absolute must for the Spirit, and then some time to regroup.
Five total games this month with the ICC play coming up. For the Portland Thorns, they'll be hosting that at Providence Park. And the Women's Cup will be happening in Louisville. Rodman's lead gets set back.
And I guess a good thing for Washington is they're not involved in either of those tournaments. So, as we were saying, they can rest the legs and let the others play out and pick up the knocks.
Bounces to Bogelski. Sullivan redirects. If you are the Spirit, who have struggled to get on the board consistently, where are you attacking this Portland side that can be so strong defensively?
To me, it's on the width with Trinity Rodman. Such a wonderful player, and if they can get her, there she's just flicking the ball on. They tried a little 1-2 there with Ashley Sanchez. Doesn't come off. But that combination where they can get Trinity Rodman behind the back four into some space. Her pace is electric. No one's going to catch her. And as she's bombing towards the line, she can whip the ball in for the likes of Sanchez and Hatch. But they need to free her up into space behind the back four of Portland. Easier said than done. But if they can do it, then I think they're going to get lots of joy tonight.
Bit of a misplay there from Portland. Washington aims to take advantage. Bailey sends it in. Sanchez can't chase it down. Coffey beats her to it. Rodman working from out wide. O'Hara into the box. Coffey just saves a corner.
Good play by Washington, just probing. You can see the ability of those, that sort of front three of Hatch, Sanchez, and Rodman. We've got Tara McKeown as well in there. They're a real threat when they're on the front foot.
A little too strong on that roll, centering for McKeown. Rocky Rodriguez outlets it to her right. Cuica, a long missile downfield, finds Sugita in stride. Christine Sinclair bounces it. Not much of a problem for Aubrey Kingsbury.
Yeah, Kingsbury, body behind the ball, good goalkeeping. Didn't have too much power. Sugita doing so well there to turn inside and lay it off to Christine Sinclair, and she is allowed to run at the goal. She hits it, it comes off the turf a few times. It loses a lot of its pace, but Kingsbury, as all good goalkeepers should do, getting body fully behind that ball.
Into the 15th minute at Segra Field in Leesburg, Virginia. Hour delayed start. Neither side getting on the board. Washington starting off with a bit of a pep in its step. Aggressive up front on defense and getting looks in that attacking third. Couple runs for Portland. Neither side getting success. McKeown tripped up but hangs on. Rodman speeds up the side. Chips it to an empty post.
Not sure what that was from Rodman. It wasn't a good cross, that's for certain. She used to whip that in with pace. Normally does a lot better than that. Although her greatest strength is cutting inside and running at the defense. A wonderful player with close control, Trinity Rodman. One of the up-and-coming stars at age 20 years of age. Here she is putting pressure on.
Rodman applies the pressure and stops it up there. This could still be dangerous. Rodman, wide for O'Hara. Low cross, headed down, Sinclair. Ryan can't clear. Continued trouble, and the throw in stays with Washington, the Spirit relentless up front.
Yeah, Portland putting themselves in some real trouble there. Credit Spirit with that pressure, but Bella Bixby taking a big risk. And Trinity Rodman there nearly blocked that ball into the net. Goalkeeper got away with one.
A lot of numbers committed forward. Washington save what could have been a great counter. Now Sanchez lifts it high.
Good stuff from the home side. A goal now would really help them, give them the confidence against this top of the table Portland team. And they're certainly creating lots of opportunities and little half moments in and around the box. Problem with Portland is if you don't score when you've got the chances, you might not get that many chances later in the game. So for Trinity Rodman, Ashley Hatch and company, they've got to take these chances when they do fall their way.
Cuica tries to spin free from Hatch. Portland will maintain. Five combined shots. Portland putting the only one on goal a couple moments ago from Christine Sinclair. Game with a lot of movement so far. Get the feeling this could change in the blink of an eye. Klingenberg gets it away from a chasing Rodman.
You would think this match would be a home match for Washington that they would enjoy, but the stats at Segra Field are not good. They normally prefer Audi Field. Five matches played this year at Segra Field, not a single win for Washington Spirit. They don't like the pitch. They don't like the surface. The coach, Chris Waters, told us on a few occasions that they don't think it's a good surface to play on. It's a bit sandy. So it's your home patch, and yet no wins in five. Maybe they can turn it around today, but it's not been a happy home for the Spirit.
Handball whistled and it'll go back to Washington. Well, at least some good news for the Spirit side is this is the final regular season match at Segra Field. So hopefully going on a high note if you're Chris Ward and company.
Yeah, it might not be their lucky pitch, but they're very lucky that Sophia Smith hasn't started for Portland Thorn. So maybe that luck is changing. You've got to fancy that Marissa Everett, as good as she is not anywhere near the same threat that Sophia Smith would be.
Again, no word on why the change was made. Only report was that Sophia Smith was deemed ineligible just before kick, and the change was made to insert Marissa Everett.
It's an interesting word, ineligible. It suggests maybe a COVID protocol or something else, because if she's injured, surely they would just say, well, she picked up an injury in the warm-up. So it does make you wonder what the actual reason is.
Hard to tell at this point. Any information we will relay. As a free kick develops off the coffee foul. Be remiss if we didn't highlight, even though Sophia Smith is not playing. It is her 22nd birthday. Tough she doesn't get to enjoy it. Coffee stomping down on Hatch there. A little over commission. Andy Sullivan, fifth year pro out of Stanford. Well, good ball in, headed up, but directed outwards. Booted away by Ryan.
Bodies coming together there, and Spirit asking for the free kick, but not given by referee Jeremy Scheer.
Sinclair takes a hard shoulder from Brooks.
And Brooks is pointing back and saying, you didn't give me the free kick earlier. You can see the commitment from Washington Spirit and the desperate desire. Have a look here. Goes for the ball, heads it, and then gets hit. And Brooks is saying, well, surely that's a foul on me. Referee says, no. Doesn't see it that way.
Jeremy Shear, our referee in this one. Sauerbrunn. Another 10th year vet of the league. Finds Rodriguez. Working through the middle. Can't reach Sugita. Sinclair recovers. Trying the outside again. Cross up top. Fails to reach Rodriguez. Now Klingenberg. Skips it through. Goes back with the Spirit. Portland's had some more pace, slower buildups of possessions. Not getting very close into that attacking third, though.
Yeah, good defense by Spirit so far, keeping them a long distance from the goals. And even Christine Sinclair's one shot on target was from all of around about 25 yards. Whereas when the Washington Spirit get forward, they're getting into the box, causing problems. Here's Rodman's pace again.
Sends it up top. Doesn't reach Mikion, but stays with Washington. Sanchez drops to O'Hara. Down near the end line, Rodman's cross. Hits ahead, but Hatch can't direct it home.
Great cross from Trinity Rodman. That's what I say, getting behind the lines there, she is so dangerous. She knows where Ashley Hatch is. Those two have combined on so many occasions, and it's a beautiful ball into that far post. Just slipped in. Kelly O'Hara there just slips it into Trinity Rodman. She gets her head up. She knows exactly where Ashley Hatch is, and it's just maybe a couple inches too high. Otherwise, she heads that into an empty net in that far corner there. Not much Bella Bixby could have done from all of 2 yards out for Ashley Hatch.
Hatch playing her 100th career regular season game tonight, leads the Spirit in goals. She's coming off a performance where she got the lone goal in the 64th. And ending in a 1-1 draw at Louisville back on Friday.
You mentioned the draws they've had. The match before that was a 3-3 draw at North Carolina Courage, which was not a bad performance. The match before that, a 0-0 home draw to Orlando. Somebody needs to tell Washington Spirit they actually should be going for wins, not draws.
The points are piling, but the time of the season has come where Washington can't really accept many more draws. They've got to get three. One isn't going to cut it when you're 15 games in the books and only have 12 points logged on the table.
You're 9 points behind the playoff line. So you've played more games than the others. You're 9 points, which is three wins. It's a lot. This is a tough league. It's a very close league. It's not easy to rack up three wins on the trot. Very few teams have done that. Portland themselves have had a draw in their last match. Followed before that, or previously a couple of wins. Even they haven't got three on the trot at this moment in time in their last three matches. So it's not easy to do. 9 points, a lot to make up for Washington Spirit.
Washington has forced a couple of clearing miscues on the part of Portland. There's another right there. So far, haven't made them pay. Even 3-3 in the shot column. The 24th minute in Virginia. O'Hara. Sullivan spins away from trouble. Everett, the one headhunting up front, taking the spot of Sophia Smith at the last moments, making just her 7th appearance of the season and 4th start. Missed a lot of games after the opener due to an injury.
Just the one goal in 6 games, though, so not a prolific scorer. Got that goal against Gotham in that 5-0 win. So if she gets service, she's a very good player. Again, it's almost unfair of us to try and compare her to Sophia Smith. Nobody lives, or hardly anybody lives, with that comparison. That's how good she is. 8 goals in her last 5 games, Sophia Smith. And then she scored a couple for the US against Colombia as well, I think it was. So, you know, even Trinity Rodman's figures start to pale against Sophia Smith.
Coffee, a good ball to an open Sugita, but she cannot reel it in with the right.
What a ball. What a fantastic ball. And Hina Sugita, you got to do better there. Got to kill that ball and bring it down and at least get the shot on target. But have a look here. Sam Coffey, no wonder they see her as the USA's future midfielder. That is a fantastic ball. And Hina Sugita expected to do better than that because she's such a quality player.
Fittingly, Sam Coffey during the CONCACAFs getting the call-up when Ashley Hatch of Washington got injured during play. Didn't end up appearing for the U.S. Women's National Team, but goes to speak to how highly she's thought of within that program.
Yeah, a rookie in her first season, Sam Coffey, just 23 years of age. What a talent. It's a talent when other coaches, and we've spoken to many other coaches who've played Portland, and they often refer to Sam Coffey. So to make that sort of impact as a rookie, that's absolutely brilliant.
O'Hara finds Rodman. Another hard low cross. Skied up. Sanchez doesn't make much of it. Bounces to Bogelski. Spins her way past Sugita. Barely sneaks it through. Hatch against Rodriguez. Now past Cuica. Knocked down by Coffey, but recovered. Mickey Owen can't do much with it, and it's cleared. Portland not committing the same numbers forward, confident in their defensive strategy, but not over-eager to launch a counterattack and commit numbers.
And for them, one of the ways that they could play the system was to have Sophia Smith as that breakaway counterattack player, which she did so effectively on the last few occasions, able to counter from midfield. You just wonder if the likes of Jasmine Ryan here has the same sort of effect or not.
Ryan brings it in close. Crosses it, headed down, Ryan! No, that's Everett, but she can't finish. A late closeout from the back line, but that brings on the first corner of the match.
Sugita with the header there, and maybe that header should have been finished. Beautiful ball in from Jasmine Ryan, but have a look at Sugita coming in here at the far post. Gets up, well, to be fair, she was under all sorts of pressure. Maybe she was trying to head it to Everett as opposed to score, because she was under such pressure, so I'll take that one back. She does get it to Everett, and Everett gets her shot blocked, but lovely combination play, all started by Yasmin Ryan.
Staub, the one knocking it out. Corner, delivered near post, directed out front. Cuica curls it off target.
And that's the quality of Portland Thorns for you, that they're under pressure for a while, and then they can break away and create that opportunity. They've now had a couple, and both of them have featured Hina Sugita, the first time unable to control the ball at the far post, the second with a lovely header to Marissa Everett, and she's just unable to tap it in there from 5 yards out.
Everett now not alone up there. Ryan giving a body up front as well. You can see this Portland side gaining confidence these last few minutes. And here's a crucial takeaway. Sinclair finds Sugita. Gives it back. Everett just over. Those two connected a moment ago. Couldn't finish. Same result just moments later.
And that for me is a better chance for Marissa Everett. She's got time on the ball. The pass coming in from Christine Sinclair to Sugita. Sugita, lovely ball in. Perfect waiting. It's come to Marissa Everett. She's got a hit target for me. Yes, maybe the keeper saves it, but you can't stick it over the crossbar from there. You've got to go left or right, or even if it's at the keeper, force the keeper to do something. Marissa Everett letting Aubrey Kingsbury off the hook there. Some worrying times for Coach Chris Ward for the Spirit. From a nice, bright, early start, it's been Portland Thorns creating three very good chances in the last 7 or 8 minutes, and that's got to be a concern for the coach.
Sinclair slips it through. Almost bounces to Rodriguez. Headed centrally for Rodman, doesn't reach her. Portland can march their way upfield once again. Sinclair. Rodriguez gets to a bit of a collision. Knocks down Sullivan, but the thorns continue. Sam Coffey works it wide. Cuica against Hatch. Sidesteps around with Coffey again. A high arcer right in front. And a successful push from that back line. Make it an easy roll for Kingsbury.
It's got too much time on it, hasn't it? That cross gives defenders chance to get in the way. As you say, use their body, bump the attackers. You've got to whip the ball in with a little bit more pace if you're going to test the defenders. But that's a small criticism of what has been a very, very good last 10 minutes by the visitors, Portland Thorns. They've looked really sharp. Sugita's been involved with absolutely everything. Christine Sinclair pulling some of the strings. Just tough for Marissa Everett, just filling in for Sophia Smith and unable to take any of the chances that have been given to her by Sugita.
Whistle away from play. Word there to either Rocky Rodriguez or Andy Sullivan, possibly both. Sullivan's been in the center of a couple of tough on and off ball fights. He's opening 31 minutes. And now a breakthrough here for Sanchez.
What a pity, she does so well. It's the most brilliant turn in midfield. Sells a dummy to half the Portland midfield. And then goes and puts a poor pass in that goes straight to Bella Bixby.
It's those looks that are so tantalizing when you see it. But just the finishing touch isn't there. It's been that way for both teams so far. It was Washington mostly early, Portland of late. The reason, still a scoreless draw.
Thing is, Portland can get away with it. They're away from home. They're top of the table. They're missing Sophia Smith. There's not the same pressure on them. They're going to have plenty of games, and you would think they're going to make the top six anyway, no matter what happens. But for Washington Spirit, this has actually become the do-or-die time of the season. We've been talking about it in the last few weeks and saying this is a must-win and a must-win. I think we've got to the point where it is a must-win. If they don't win today, then I think they're done, Washington Spirit. It'd be near-nigh impossible to make the playoffs. So they can't afford to keep missing. They can't afford not to take their chances, or at least take one chance more than Portland take.
Ryan gets a step down the left side. Enters the box. A low roller tapped up and punched down by Kingsbury. Everett, for a third time in the last 10 minutes, can't finish point blank. Here comes Washington the other way. Rodman speeding down the middle. Coffey slides to stop the pass across. Rodman regains her footing. Back for Sullivan. Sinclair on her back. She fires in, a diving save by Bixby. Hatch swarmed by Hubley. And not much of a third try there.
Wow, Bixby with a decent save there from Andy Sullivan at one end. And a minute earlier, Marissa Everett with another chance at the other end. So goalkeeper's getting busy and it's threatening to score, isn't it? Andy Sullivan, decent strike. Goalkeeper parries it and Hatch just unable to get there early enough. Too many white shirts around her. But it's end-to-end soccer, and there's definitely a whole bunch of chances, but none of them yet hit the back of the net.
Certainly no shortage of shots. About 35 minutes through, a combined 14, 7 per side, each with two on target. That last one, the best of the bunch. Sanchez gets it jarred loose. Coffey can't quite center, but it stays with Portland.
By the way, Coffey's made a couple of really good interceptions, last-ditch interceptions. She made one from a Rodman pass a couple of minutes ago on the edge of her box. She does it too often for it to be luck. Very good reader of the game is young Sam Coffey.
Ryan gets doubled. Wheels to Rodriguez. Hubley. Trying to work that right side. Sugita taps it off. Cuica looking to step around. Mikione. A good chip towards a charging Everett that doesn't reach her. Both these sides sitting around or exactly at 0.8 expected goals to this point.
Yeah, they both should have scored at least once, you would think. Some very good chances for Marissa Everett. Really good chances. And at the other end, don't think they've been as clear-cut for Washington Spirit, to be honest. But they've been just probing around the edge of the box, and you expect maybe with a little lucky bump here or there, or lucky bounce rather, that something might have gone their way. It hasn't as yet.
You'd have to think it's the shot on that last push that led to the diving Bixby stop that accounts for most of it. Sprawling effort from Rodman, but it still finds Ryan. A hard one that's just too high.
Yeah, decent effort, but again, not testing the goalkeeper, and there's no point putting shots over the crossbar. That means the goalkeeper has nothing to do. You want to at least test the goalkeeper. They all make mistakes. They all let balls slip through their hands or drop them forward for a striker following up to score. So, but at least give Jasmine Ryan credit. She's been very positive, been attacking for most of this first half.
Beautiful ball ahead. Rodman just can't chase it down. Hubley, the Iron Woman, there first. I got to say, I feel bad for that chair that was on the end of that Ryan shot on the other side.
Yeah, lots of power from Jasmine Ryan. But her strength has been in trying to slip balls through for Marissa Everett in particular, and Sugita done that very well first half as Jasmine Ryan.
Ball comes loose. Portland trying to approach upfield. Taken back by Brooks. Wide for Rodman. What's Washington done well to lead to most of their chances up to this point?
They've been high pressing very well. Lots of turnover ball on the edge of the box, putting Bella Bixby under all sorts of pressure. Rodman's had a few little opportunities down the right-hand side in which has whipped in good crosses. See, that sort of ball doesn't work for me. Knocking it long to the front, you're going to be lucky to pick up loose ball, which they have. But their real strength comes from playing out wide and down the flanks.
A little bit of a miscue from Bogelski. And that one hits her hand.
See, even there, Bogelski had the chance to play it out wide to Ashley Hatch and just lost control of the ball. Ends up being a turnover ball, and Portland can push all their players forward now. As she goes into tackle here, it just comes off her hand. There you go, off her elbow.
Sauerbrunn. Finds Coffey. Down for Ryan. Tries to poke it through the legs of Brooks. Unsuccessful. Nonetheless, the Thorns maintain it. Coffey finds Ryan. She's got space. Yasmin Ryan gets stopped.
Good
Another
save.
Sprawling effort from
yeah,
Kingsbury.
Just saying the same thing, Aubrey Kingsbury. Very, very good save. Yasmin Ryan playing so well. She hits that with lots of power to the goalkeeper's left. The goalkeeper makes a really, really good save. You do think a goal has got to come soon for Portland Thorns in particular, because they seem to be creating the majority of good chances.
Right towards midfield for Sauerbrunn. The anchor of this field unit for Portland, as we roll into the 40th minute, still scoreless. Misplay. Ryan can't reel it in. Led ahead for Hatch. She gives it off. Open chance. Sanchez denied point blank by Bixby.
What a chance there for Sanchez. Absolutely brilliant ball. Hatch doing so well to make the play. Bella Bixby, congrats on coming out big and brave and strong and making the stop from Ashley Sanchez. And that was the real big chance that they've been looking for. Washington Spirit came their way. I just wondered if Ashley Sanchez could have just chipped the goalkeeper, but maybe she tried to. In the end, the keeper closing down that space very quickly with a top-class save.
Another potentially dangerous takeaway from Bailey. The Thorns get some numbers back to slow this approach. Hatch takes a shoulder from Coffey that isn't called. Got her right on the back. No one denies that Sam Coffey is willing to play in the trenches.
Described as a quarterback by Rian Wilkinson, someone who controls the entire game from that sort of position just ahead of the two or three center backs. Does a great job, Sam Coffey.
Cuica trying to beat out Bogelski. Washington back there first, but sets up the second corner of the match.
Here's this Ryan shot and Kingsbury save. It's close enough to the keeper to expect her to make the save. You just wonder if Yasmin Ryan could have been a bit more clinical. Here's the other one. It goes to Ashley Hatch, but it's the immediate ball here to Sanchez. What a great ball. Sanchez got time. She goes to flick it. To be fair to her, she tries to. She doesn't get enough height on it, and it comes off the shoulder of Bella Bixby. Good save from the keeper. So close for Washington Spirit.
For Sanchez, right idea, imperfect execution. Kim Portland nail that second step here off this corner.
Normal discussion from referee to players pushing and shoving in the box, which we get every game in every league in the world. I sometimes wonder why referees don't just leave it, and if the defender does something wrong, you blow for a penalty.
Sam Coffey. Right in front, headed up top. Klingenberg lofts it down, tapped up, and just over the crossbar, and who else, it's Everett again.
It's been a really frustrating first half from Marissa Everett. She could easily have had 1, 2, 3, even 4 goals. Klingenberg thought she was going to shoot, but she puts in a fantastic ball, and it's a flick on from Everett. Could she have maybe caught it within a thigh and then volleyed it, got it under control first, because the flick on lacked direction, it lacked pace. You just wonder whether Sophia Smith would have taken some of these chances that have fallen to Marissa Everett. That's what the fans will be asking. And it's a fair question, because I've got it here. 4 decent chances for Marissa Everett, and she hasn't so far been able to take any.
Some more numbers up now for the Thorns. They lead the shot battle 10-8. Both sides with 3 shots on goal. And yet still 0-0 in the 43rd. Coffey with the swipe. Out for Cuica. Plays it off Bogelski. Masterfully wins it back. You get the sense that it'll be tough to dethrone whoever scores first.
I think it's 2 very good sides. You wouldn't think that Washington had the worst points per game record. You can expect Portland to have the best points per game record, but Washington the worst? It's very difficult to get your head around the Challenge Cup finalists and reigning champions being this bad in the NWSL season. As you said, it's mostly draws. It's not that they've been hammered, or they've gone through a big losing phase. They've just drawn so many of their games. And I'm sure if you ask Chris Ward, he'll say time and time again, we should have won the majority of those games, or we could have won them. And here we are again. They're sitting at 0-0. It's just the feature of Washington this season.
Can they change that in the closing minutes of this first half? O'Hara ambles towards the middle. Rodman battling, keeps it alive. Sanchez spins it off target. Would have been a tough angle regardless.
Yeah, it's poor defending there from Portland. If you're going to see the ball over, you can't allow Rodman to pull it back into a dangerous area like that. Nearly got punished. Sanchez again, not hitting target this time. That's been one of the issues of this first half. Chances for both sides, not too many hitting target. And when they do, in fairness to both Bella Bixby in picture and Aubrey Kingsbury, both goalkeepers have made some decent saves.
Bixby sends it ahead. Down with Rodman. Leaves it off for O'Hara. There will be no stoppage time to cap off this first half. So the last push coming here from Washington. They will whistle it dead beforehand.
Well, a balanced first half. They both had chances. They both had some great attacking moves. Goalkeepers have made some really important saves for both sides. I think it's perfectly set up for what should be a cracking second half, hopefully with lots of goals.
Both offenses clicking, a combined 19 shots and 6 on goal. Both sides with more than an expected goal up through 45 minutes. Should be an eventful second half from Segra Field when we come back after a 1 hour delay. Both sides firing on all cylinders, but still scoreless at the end of the first half.
Happy birthday, Julian.
A full half in the books, 20 combined shots, more than an expected goal per side, but none on the board between Washington and Portland at Segra Field in Leesburg, Virginia tonight. Alongside Gary Bailey, Brandon Ross here with you. So much happening in that first half, so many good chances, just missing those finishing touches.
Yep, a couple of players in particular you've got to pick out. Marissa Everett, I picked out four good chances. She could have really had a fantastic first half, but couldn't take any of them. Yasmin Ryan had a great chance from 8 yards. Sugita miscontrolled when she was 5 or 6 yards out. And on the other side, Ashley Sanchez had the best shot of the entire, best chance of the entire match. One-on-one against Bella Bixby, the keeper, making a fantastic save. So I thought there was lots of entertainment. No goals, but positive open play at times from both sides. And hopefully we get more.
And Portland in the road, Whites, Washington in the home, Blues. Rodman crosses in, great chance, Bailey sails it upstairs. Almost roofed it, but just misses.
What a chance, you got to score from there though. Again, another great opportunity in this match that's going to waste. Good work done there, Trinity Rodman. Head up straight away, looking, pace down the line. This is where she's at her absolute best. And Bailey comes in, got to get over the ball, Dorian Bailey, and she doesn't, she gets under it. That is another great opportunity. Washington Spirit have got to take these chances. They've got to get these 3 points. Otherwise, they will regret those sort of misses.
Bigelski across, too far in front of Rodman. Can't quite clear it. Hatch. Back towards the box. Mickey Owen. Winds it out. Sanchez. Just misses Hatch.
The idea was good. It was Sanchez was looking up as if she was going to cross it. At the last moment, she turned her foot. Disguised pass, but it was so good. It fooled her own teammate, Ashley Hatch. And this is what Sanchez and Hatch and Rodman, they're so good together. There are three of them up front. And yet the best chances have fallen to the likes of Dorian Bailey. Best chance, I should say, singular. Dorian Bailey over the crossbar from 4 or 5 yards out.
Sinclair slips it to Everett. Everett takes a tumble and sets up the best free kick opportunity of the match. Sullivan booked in the process. And a great opportunity for Portland.
It is Christine Sinclair doing so well there to win the ball. And as Everett goes, Andy Sullivan's coming back. She knows she has to stop the attack somehow in the end. Gives away the free kick and the yellow card. But all started with Christine Sinclair. Quick turnover ball, plays it into Everett. And now they've got a great chance on the edge of the box.
First free kick from this close the entire match. It's been Portland with the corners. And now this near range opportunity. Yasmin Ryan, who missed a good look earlier.
She had a good shot save from Kingsbury in the first half as well. Yasmin Ryan been very positive, very creative around the fringes of the box. Christine Sinclair's hobbling there. Took a bit of a knock, but such a legend of a player for Canada. And of course for Portland Thorns.
A yellow card caution.
You think Yasmin Ryan goes direct or looks for a loft in?
In the 48th minute.
She's got options for either. Trinity Rodman just smiling, but from that angle, maybe try and get it far post for the header. Let's see.
The yellow goes to Brooks. Ryan goes direct off the crossbar. Did she touch it? They say no, and Kingsbury will clear.
Kingsbury says no, but it does look, it did look like she got the faintest of fingertips on that one. Let's say we'll have a look at it again, hopefully. Good goalkeeper, Kingsbury. Good shot in the end. Just inches away from being a brilliant shot. Again, you need to get it under the crossbar for it to have any chance of counting, but extremely close. Very difficult skill, that getting the ball over the wall and bringing it down again.
Brooks, wearing the yellow there, gets her third of the season. Again, five forces a one-game suspension. Taking another look at the yellow that set that up. It's a little trip up there on Sinclair.
Everett there gets hit pretty hard by Andy Sullivan. That's the yellow card.
Yeah, hence the confusion. It's actually Brooks who got the yellow.
Oh, was it Brooks? My apologies.
Yeah, I guess they pegged Brooks for a little step down before Sullivan even got the chance.
I just assumed it was because Andy Sullivan came in so hard.
Sinclair taps it for Sauerbrunn. When there are two cardable offenses on the same play, sometimes it's a little bit of a fair misread.
I think the referee probably decided on Brooks, and then when Andy Sullivan came along, he thought, I can't give two yellow cards, so I'll just stick with the first one. Pace at which Trinity Rodman closed down. You see how that turnover ball comes from Rodman closing down so quickly, and the defenders have to rush their pass.
A little too strong for Mickey Owen. And Rodriguez sprays it out wide. Bigelski draped all over Sugita. Rodman takes it back.
Well, as tough a time as Washington Spirit have had, talking to Chris Ward, he said the vibe in the locker room is really good at the moment, and that's what we also hear from the players through the grapevine. So whatever Chris Ward is doing, he's got a happy camp there at Washington Spirit, which is amazing under the circumstances. You'd think, knowing professional players and having been in the game for so long myself, it's players do start to turn on coaches. So the fact that it's a happy camp, that's a huge credit to the coach, Chris Ward.
Looking to lead his team on a late season run. Time running low for Washington. Draws not sufficient. They need wins. Meanwhile, Sugita, well ahead of the pack, gets the left foot free, fires wide of the back post.
Sugita, such a threat down that right-hand side. Just couldn't quite put her foot around that and whip it into that far post. But just the fact that she gets in those shooting positions. Again, this is all without Sophia Smith, their number one striker. 11 goals in 11 matches, 8 in the last 5. And even without her, and away from home, and at the Champions, and they're still creating more chances than Washington. I assume their XG, their expected goals, are still higher than Washington. Away from home, lots of travel because they played Friday, so done a lot of traveling, and still they put on a decent performance, Portland Thorns. Exceptional side.
Spirit will start back with their keeper, Kingsbury. Playing her 100th match with Washington tonight. A little bit of attack around. Gets back out to midfield. Everett drops it. Coffee goes left. Coffey tries to swing it centrally. Can't quite turn into momentum for Washington. Iarker through the center channel. Winds up with Sinclair. Bailey sweeps in from behind to take it back.
I've just been trying to figure out what it is about Washington that seems to be failing in this season. In fact, we've tried to figure it a lot of times. Oh, good ball in.
Sneaks it through. Ryan trying to dribble her way around. Leaks it for Everett. Rodriguez. Klingenberg gives it back. Rocky Rodriguez from long range.
That's not one of her best. Normally a very good player, Rocky Rodriguez. Just nowhere near Kingsbury's goal there. But just to complete my point, I was looking at what is it they're doing wrong in this stretch of the NWSL season that they didn't do before when they were champions and Challenge Cup finalists. And some of their stats, they've got the third lowest completion rate of passes in the opposition half. So when they're attacking, they only get 67% of their passes find someone. They lose a lot of possession in the opponent's half. In fact, here they can't even play out of their own half.
Everett. That must be the fifth or sixth chance. She just cannot finish from close range. Both sides lacking that touch.
Yeah, it was tough for Marissa Everett. Obviously, is every time we look at that, we go, what would Sophia Smith do? When you compare to the best, it's not looking good. But having said that, she's had five or six very decent opportunities. Marissa Everett, she needs to do better. It's a tough situation. But again, to complete my point about Washington, they've got to have more decent passes in the opposition half. They haven't been able to do that. And if they can, maybe they can start to turn their season around.
Last time these two sides met, it was a 1-1 draw at Providence Park in Portland. Both of those goals came in the second half. Will there be a breakthrough here in Virginia tonight? Sent a long way down, centered up, Everett tries to nudge it home, can't sneak it through. Sanchez takes a bump from Cuica and will play on. Smith was the goal scorer for Portland in that match. It was Hatch for Washington.
There's a surprise with those two goal scorers. We're getting to that point where managers start looking at the bench, coaches start looking at their bench to see who they can bring on. I'm just wondering for Washington Spirit, Elmar's an option for them. They've got Baggett, formerly DiBiase, on the bench and Elwell. So you just wonder if some fresh legs might come on soon for Washington Spirit.
Sanchez fails to reach Rodman. Backline holding firm. Sub is waiting to come on for Washington. Can they get one more good push before that new body enters? Sanchez, a good tap ahead. That one can't reach McKeown, or McKeown, excuse me. Bigelski. Pressure sustains as Sanchez down that right flank. Bixby, a solid catch. And Sauerbrunn is grabbing at her right knee, struggling to get up.
That was a good bit of spell from Washington Spirit. The ball was bouncing around in their box and just felt maybe someone might get a touch on it, but in the end, good defending from Portland Thorns. You can see there's a few players, yeah, they're wheezing and gasping. It's been a tough 60 minutes so far or thereabouts. And that's why you look to the bench and think who else might come on. Of course, for Portland Thorns, Morgan Weaver's on the bench. Here's that moment again. It gets pulled back. And you're thinking, is it going to reach Tara McKeown? A turn from Dorian Bailey. That gets blocked. So good pressure from the home side. Once again, not able to find the back of the net.
Sauerbrunn going down, unable to get up after making that step to cut off that pass to the top of the six. And it gets Sauerbrunn, someone with eons of experience, 15 years as a professional, 10 in this league, a four-time defender of the year. So Rian Wilkinson rallies the troops in this little interlude.
He's done a really good job this season, Rian Wilkinson. We spoke to her early in the season when she first arrived, and she was concerned that this team that's in a rebuild under her as the new coach doesn't get compared to, you know, previous seasons' hugely successful sides. Well, I'm sure she's only too happy to be compared to the past now, because this team is right up there with the best they've had, sitting top of the table. And great job there by Rian Wilkinson.
Claps Rain. As the sides get ready to retake it, Sauerbrunn trying to jog this off.
Well, she's 37 years of age now, Becky Sauerbrunn, so she's taken a fair share of knocks in her time, I'm sure. Yet she still bounces up, tough as nails. Absolutely brilliant.
It will not be Sauerbrunn yet, but it will be the first substitution as we roll into the 61st for Portland. Tegan McGrady making her third appearance since the trade from San Diego, entering for Megan Klingenberg.
That's going to be the first of many changes on either side as they bring fresh legs on, and both sides will be looking to try and find a breakthrough and get some fresh thoughts on the pitch to see if they can find the gap in the opposite defense.
Ryan searching for that gap with haste. Puts too much on that pass for Sugita.
Sugita, such a willing runner down that right-hand side. There is Tegan McGrady. Interesting trade done. They brought her in and they need her on that left-hand side. Swap for Maddie Pogosh, who went the other way to San Diego.
Staub. Can't reach McKeown. A little bit of a tangle at midfield. Sinclair almost gets it through. Yasmin Ryan unable to reach. Washington the other way. McKeown sprays for Hatch. Looking to quarterback this attack as neither side has broken through here in the 62nd. 15 shots for Portland, 12 for Washington. The Spirit, 1.72 expected goals to Portland's 1.5.
So I guess it should be 2-2 at this moment in time. It's 0-0. Credit both Aubrey Kingsbury and Bella Bixby. I think there's a fair share of poor finishing as well thrown in there, especially from Marissa Everett.
Brooks wisely sends that one off of Ryan. O'Hara to take the toss.
A yellow card caution has been issued to Spirit player number 12, Andy Sullivan, in the 63rd minute.
Yeah, I heard. So if you just heard it there in the background, Andy Sullivan has been given a yellow card, so just as we had thought it was handed out her way moments ago, where it was actually Amber Brooks. Now, Andy Sullivan draws her first yellow card of the season.
Oh, there was a late tackle about a minute ago, and the referee waved play on, and he might have come back for that tackle. And I believe it actually was for that late tackle, just hearing confirmation now, so referee doing well, allowing play on, but then taking a note of who fouled and whether it was worthy of a yellow or not. Some referees don't come back and book. They tend to let it go, but referee Jeremy Shear has come back a couple of times to give bookings after his wave play on.
Misdirected pass taken by Rodman. Can't reach Bigelski, but she muscles her way back onto the ball. Sullivan. McKeown has been trying to streak ahead of the back line unsuccessfully. Stop goes all the way back to the keeper. Randa Ross, Gary Bailey, 65th minute, Zegra Fields and Virginia. A scoreless game in what has been a highly offensive affair nonetheless between the Washington Spirit and Portland Thorns. Thank you for staying with us. I know this was certainly not when you expected this game to still be being played. The hour delay will do that. We appreciate your viewership. Rodriguez. Pass back for Sauerbrunn. back off the pitch, or back on the pitch for going down that little knee trouble a moment ago. Sanchez the swipe with numbers in tow. Finds Vicky Young and she swings and misses. Rodman drags it near.
Again, missed opportunities for the home side. They've got to be taking more of these. Yeah, she feels that stress, Trinity Rodman. Mikion had the best chance. Sanchez doing so well here. Mikion says, give it to me. She's expecting it and then still misses the ball completely. You just wonder whether maybe Chris Ward might make some changes and push Trinity Rodman up and maybe take Tara Mikion off, or there's other options for him, but he might need to change things up for Washington Spirit if he's to get 3 points from this match.
In the meantime, Portland making its second change here in the 66th. Janine Becky, fourth-year pro who joined on a 3-year deal coming over from Man City, enters in the place of Marissa Everett, who has had those struggles up at the front of the pack.
I think, to be fair to Marissa Everett, she has been in the right place to at least try and finish off the chances. So you've got to give her the credit for that. But of all the chances she had to not score, and in many occasions not even really force the keeper into a decent save, that's just probably not good enough for Portland Thorns.
Sinclair to Sagita. Fires a bouncer right at Kingsbury.
Not a problem for Kingsbury, that one, nice and easy, body behind it. Never going to be a problem for a keeper of her quality. And now we start getting the subs. You start to see if there's any changes in formation, any gaps opening anywhere, and whether the player with the extra energy, such as Janine Becky, can make things happen.
Here's Becky right away, and sprawling out, Kingsbury stops the onslaught.
Could save Aubrey Kingsbury. That's not easy to do, diving out like that and holding onto the ball. Good ball in from Janine Becky. Have a look at her. She's got the energy. She makes the run. She gets it back. She puts it right in the danger. But look at the keeper diving out at feet. Has to hold onto it and nearly gets a kick in the face from Jasmine Ryan. Well, that's good handling from Aubrey Kingsbury.
And if she hadn't hung on to that, Ryan was right there to finish. But still, in the 68th, neither side with a breakthrough. Coffey works her way to her left against the traffic. Cuica gets a tap loose. Migelski keeps possession with the home Washington side. Stop. Can't reach Sanchez. O'Hara, actually. Roller, Mikion. Beat to it by Sauerbrunn. Bailey, another swipe. Sanchez moves it closer now. Mikion to the back post. Rodman, by the skin of her teeth, keeps it alive. Migelski. Working from the back of the pack. Brooks. Sullivan. Down the left side for Migelski once more. Dancing her way in on Cuica. Cross is good. Header off the woodwork again. This time it's Hatch.
That's so unlucky for Ashley Hatch. That's a great header. It really is. It's got power behind it. Smacks against the crossbar. Beautiful ball knocked in. And Ashley Hatch giving the thumbs up as well to Migelski. Migelski here, she just tries to find an angle. But beautiful ball weighted, curling in towards Ashley Hatch. And that is so close to being the opening goal. She climbs high, Ashley Hatch. She can't believe it either. The rest of the team can't believe it. What do they have to do, Washington Spirit, to get this goal? It's been a very good offensive performance without that final touch.
A player who is usually the focal point of the offense and who, to that point, had been relatively silent on her best opportunity. Like everyone else tonight, fails to finish. Into the 71st now. Portland on the attack. Becky, just a few minutes off the bench. It's forced down by Bogelski. Washington pushing the counter. Mikione. It's Sanchez. 2-on-3 moving up. Sanchez loses the handle. Takes the clear off the body. But it's back with Portland nonetheless.
That's exciting play, isn't it? Washington are having to go for it a bit more. Lots of blue jerseys up. But if you play through that press, Portland Thorns, and there's lots of space behind the back four. And that's what Christine Sinclair is trying to do, is to get them on that front foot and play in that space. But Ashley Hatch looking sharp. Rodman still full of energy. Look at that pressure from Trinity Rodman. You really feel for Washington Spirit because they should not be near the foot of the table. It's a quality side, working hard, and just not able to get the ball in the back of the net. They just can't finish off their chances.
With more points under their belt, this would be a hard-earned draw, but they can't afford that here. Cuica clings to it against the heat from Rodman. Sugita, a little stutter. Back for Rodriguez. In for Cuica. Sends across McGrady. Couldn't reach it.
Yeah, a little bit too much pace on it there for Tegan McGrady to get on the end of that one. But frustrating also for Portland. We've spoken about Washington Spirit, but they've scored 34 goals this season, Portland. Their club record is 40 in a season. So they're only 6 short of matching their record. And they've still got plenty of games left. So it has been a fantastic offensive performance by Portland Thorns, even if today they're unable to find the back of the net so far.
Yasmin Ryan taking a bit of a tumble and getting tended to by the Portland training staff.
Just going back to Ashley Hatcher's header. What a header. What a cross coming in from Bogelski. So close for Washington Spirit to get the lead, and it would have been a fantastic goal if it had gone in the back of the net. Classic forward header from Ashley Hatch. Rising high, power behind the header, inches away from being in that top corner.
Couple substitutions being made now. Yasmin Ryan will come off, replacing her Morgan Weaver, who has had a solid few games his last few matches. Ashley Sanchez also exiting, and Bailey Feist taking over on the Washington Spirit side. Feist still without a goal on this season for a team that needs offense. Perhaps that hunger essential. And for Weaver, someone who took a while to get going this season but has really caught fire these last few matches on the Portland side of affairs.
Yeah, goals against Courage and against Gotham. She's really been looking good, Morgan Weaver. Got some unusual dance routines after she scores. So I'm sure Portland fans will be hoping to see that in the next 16 minutes or so.
It's just an expression of excitement, Gary. Headed down, Sinclair tries to find Weaver. Backline on it first for Washington. Well, this is about as good of a scoreless draw up to this point that you could possibly get. 30 combined shots. 2 expected goals for Washington. More than 1.5 for Portland. the chances are there. The finishes just aren't. And if you're Chris Ward, it has to be frustrating.
Well, everything's frustrating for Chris Ward at the moment. I mean, it's not the first game where he's looked at the scoreline and gone, how did we end up like this? He said, so often they concede. On days when they score plenty, they concede too many. On days when they defend well, they don't score. He said it's just been one of those seasons that's driven him mad.
Leaks through. Feist! Fended aside. Corner kick incoming, the first of the match for Washington.
Fresh legs creating a good chance there, and once again, unable to hit the back of the net. This time, goalkeeper hand and maybe a post. Let's have a look at it again. Bailey Feist is coming in there. I wonder if she could have gone far side. She goes near side. Just the goalkeeper's hand. Good save again from Bella Bixby. And then probably the reason she couldn't go far post was she was being closed down by defenders from that angle. So in the end, good strike from Bailey Feist.
It goes in front. Punched up. It's loose. Off the follow. Bixby hangs on. Did she carry it into her own net?
It's a goal. She dropped. She was going over the line. She threw it back in play, and Ashley Hatch just scored. What an unusual situation from the goalkeeper, Bella Bixby. She just lost her balance somehow, went back into the net, had to get rid of the ball, and it goes straight to Ashley Hatch. Look at this again. Keep a bad punch, head is back. She gets it, then bumps her own play, and then just hands it straight to Hatch. She could have dropped it anywhere. Ashley Hatch can't believe it. Look, bad punch. Ball gets back. She's now going over the line. Throws it.
Although she did go over the line.
I think you're right. I think she already crossed the line, to be honest. But whether it would have been given is controversial. In the end, there's no controversy. Ashley Hatch, the top goal scorer for Washington and Spirit, gets the breakthrough. And if you're Chris Ward, you're saying, of all the chances we have had, this is the one that goes in.
Washington fans are ecstatic. Portland fans are wondering what on earth just happened. That is a goal for Ashley Hatch. Sixth of the season in her 100th career regular season match in the NWSL.
Sagita with an injury, and they can't afford to lose her. Such a wonderful player on that right-hand side in this match. Interesting talking to Rian Wilkinson about Sugita, and she said to us the other day, wonderful personality, always laughing, loved by everybody. So she's just fantastic to have in the locker room. We often see players and their ability, but to hear about them as personalities, and Sugita, one of the most favorite amongst the players.
Certainly been a lively presence. Mentioned the other day at a team dinner, she just had the entire table in shambles. That's certainly not the demeanor of the Portland side right now. Can Washington cling on for its first victory since the season opener? Or will Portland sneak its way back into this affair? Sugita, well offside.
Well, it's been a gift of a goal. And Rian Wilkinson will probably want to know from Bella Bixby just quite what the goalkeeper was doing there. But she lost her balance going backwards. I'm just surprised she threw it at Hatch. Maybe she had to react so quickly she didn't know where she was throwing it. But if you're going to throw it out, even if you have crossed the line, you hope the assistant ref doesn't see the ball go over the line. You try and throw it to one of your players to clear it, not straight to Ashley Hatch. But I guess it all happened very quickly for Bella Bixby, who, by the way, has made some fantastic saves this match. As a goalkeeper, it's a horrible feeling, and I've been there enough times to know that it's a horrible feeling when you've played well and the goal that goes in is a messy goal, because, you know, that's the one moment that's going to be shown time and time again, and no one's going to really care about all the saves you've made in the match.
Becky can't keep touch, and, you know, after this entire game with all the offense, wouldn't it be something if that's the goal that decides it?
Well, it's something for everyone, but Bella Bixby, as I said, is going to be an embarrassment to see that goal replayed many times.
So, funny enough, they have just redid the scoring. It is now down as a Bella Bixby own goal. Can her teammates make up for it? Becky pushed off. Sugita dispossessed. The foul keeps it with Washington. And you had to wonder how that would go down. Obviously, initially, you have to give it to Hatch since the whistle came late, but now it has gone down. Hatch does not get goal number 6 of the season at 75-59, an own goal for Bella Bixby.
It did look like she carried it over the line, to be honest, but my question is whether it would have been given by the assistant ref on the far side. In the end, it's a moot point because Ashley Hatch smacked it into the back of the net anyway, just in case the assistant ref wasn't sure. And now it's all about working the clock down. If you're Washington Spirit, we said at the beginning of the game, if they can get 3 points here today with a 17-day rest while other teams such as Portland are playing in tournaments and have NWSL games, it's a chance for the Spirit to recharge their batteries and make a real run at it. And this 3 points will make a huge difference for Spirit. It puts them on 15 points with Owal Rain in that last playoff place on 21. Now the difference is only 6 points. Suddenly becomes a bit more doable for Chris Ward and company.
Skips off the head of Sinclair. Right back into the waiting grasp of Washington. Now coughed up to Sugita. Trying to lead it. And just barely knocked aside by Kingsbury. Portland is not trying to exit without any points.
Well, it's 10 games ago since Portland last scored in a match. And in that time, they've scored 30 on an average of 3 per game for the last 10 games. So it's not often they draw a blank up front, but a huge slice of luck for Washington before the game, obviously, with Sophia Smith not being able to start for as still an unknown reason, but just minutes before kickoff. Because with Sophia Smith in the side and the chances that Portland have created, you do fancy the scoreline might have been very different.
In Portland, atop the table right now, but even in points with San Diego, with one less game played, not including this one, any points would be valuable. Almost sneaks ahead to Sugita. Bigelski, just a soft touch on it.
So if they were to draw this, Portland Thorns, they remain top on goal difference ahead of San Diego Wave, having played the same number of matches, which still makes it a fantastic season for the Thorns.
Well, a draw puts them 1 point in front.
A draw would, yes, if they could pull one back.
Coffey with Kuika in tow. In front, a good boot off the pipe, rebound, put home! Sinclair, the veteran, makes it level in the closing minutes.
Unbelievable for Washington Spirit. Aubrey Kingsbury can't believe that just when they get ahead, they get pulled back. Christine Sinclair, the quickest to react. That's a question mark against the defenders here. Ball comes in from Sam Coffey. It's a great stride that comes in over the crossbar. Could the keeper have tipped it over? Could maybe Andy Sullivan have got to the loose ball first? Not so, but Kelly Hubley with the strike. Great strike from a defender especially. Fantastic strike. And Christine Sinclair, quickest to react. And disaster for Washington Spirit when they were gifted a goal. And now it's all back to level once again.
Portland's in position for 1 point if this scoreline holds. This was the exact final score of the meeting at Providence Park back in May. Will another side tack on one more?
Oh, can you believe it? Chris Ward must have been thinking, my luck has turned at last, or our luck has turned. 1-0 up, no Sophia Smith. Chances of getting 3 points looking good, and now this draw will not be enough. It will be a disaster for Washington Spirit. will leave them a long way off, 8 points off that playoff spot, having played more games than everybody else around them.
A good slip through from Weaver. Down that right flank, the cross goes in, aiming for Becky. It hits the deck. And is punched out by Washington. 86th minute. A game that was scoreless for the first 75 has seen two goals in the span of 8 minutes. Both courtesy of Portland, but one an own goal. The other just a couple minutes back. Sent in by Christine Sinclair for her fifth of the season. Hatch leaks it forward. A good finishing touch. Finds Feist just outside the box. Leaves it towards the middle. The shot goes up and just over from Mickey Owen.
What a chance that was for Tara Mickey Owen. If you want to make a name for yourself, stick that one in the top corner and win this match by 2-1. Bella Bixby with a bit of cramp in that calf muscle. But again, just not able to finish this off, Washington Spirit. The only goal they've got was a gift. Neat play around the edges of the box. Lovely ball back in here to Tara McKeown. Settles herself up. She's got time. Really got to do better with that from, what is it, 15, 16 yards out. Gets under that ball a little bit too much and opportunity lost.
Immediately grabs that left calf. Getting tended to by the training staff here. 87th minute. The balance of this game still the same, but a lot has happened these last few minutes. Wow. The own goal from Bixby. The follow-up by Sinclair. With 35 shots between the sides. Only one scored goal between them.
Yep, I know the own goal is, given all the chances that could have gone in, that's such a pity for Bella Bixby, who's had a great game. She's really struggling with that left calf. But if this draw, if this result remains, it's the last 14 matches for Washington will be 10 draws and 4 losses. You cannot succeed with 10 draws and 4 losses. It's just a disaster of a season for the champions.
It's an unbelievable amount of ties. Time running low in this season and in this game to try to secure those critical 3 points. Header directed down to the near. Worked back for Amber Brooks. Leading ahead. Feist was streaking, but it stopped up before it reaches her. Dorian Bailey. Out left for Rodman. Coughs it right up. Will Portland strike out in front? Will it be Washington? Or will neither emerge with multiple points, leaving the other in the dust? Rodman getting another warning for the trip up. Sugita refastening her laces here. And to give credit to Trinity Rodman to some extent, who, you know, gets the tough end of one before and follows up there. By her standards, this is a pretty clean game.
Yep. Unlucky there, because that could have easily been a foul against Quica, the first one, and in favor of Trinity Rodman. I think that's the sort of question she's asking.
90th minute. Off the top of the head. Weaver kept off by Brooks. 22. Fending off 22 in that fight at the top of the penalty area.
Crucial bit of added time coming up now for Washington Spirit. 2.5 expected goals versus over three for Portland. So, again, give the visitors credit without Sophia Smith away from home, having traveled across the country. 5 hours travel on the plane and all the time difference, and still they come up with more expected goals than their hosts.
Well, plenty of time to come. 8 minutes of stoppage time, starting with this Portland free kick, very deep into attacking territory.
Wow, 8 minutes. All right. So plenty could happen in this match.
Sent in. A big leap, but Kingsbury right on top of it. Starting to start a fast counter the other way. Rodman. Good defense by Cuica. Natalia Cuica has been showing up, coming up those wings throughout the course of tonight's match. Long goal for Portland came from Christine Sinclair. Buckle your seatbelts, grab your popcorn. It's been fun, and we've got a little more time here. Sugita. Ahead for Weaver. Dances into open space. Weaver fires and scores! Off the bench again, she gives Portland the 2-1 lead in extra time.
Unbelievable, Portland Thorns. What a team they are. Fantastic that away from home they can come back from 1-0 down. And Morgan Weaver allowed to cut in on her left foot. Have a look, you've got to play her down the line away from trouble, but she's allowed to come inside here. And then she opens up an angle. Great finish from Morgan Weaver, but Sam Staub allowing her to come inside, and that gives Kingsbury absolutely no chance whatsoever. But without Sophia Smith away from home, once again Portland Thorns produce the goods. But heartbreak for Washington Spirit, and this result, if it remains, might very well end Washington's season.
This was a Washington side that obviously took its bumps when the NWSL ruled that Jaden Shaw could play. They were, for a lot of the time, expected to land her. But then her discovery rights went up. San Diego, the ones claiming her and already making an impact, scoring in her first game. But nonetheless, no reinforcements came for Washington. And without another sign of life in these final minutes of stoppage time, that likely kills their postseason hopes.
What's also frustrating is the only goal they've got was a mistake by Bella Bixby, who fell over the line with the ball. Other than that, they've created chances but haven't been able to finish them themselves. You expect so much more from Trinity Rodman, Ashley Hatch, Ashley Sanchez. Last season, they were absolutely on fire. Ashley Hatch, Golden Boot winner. And what's happened this season? It's just, maybe it's the hangover of a great season. Maybe it just happens that you become champions and then you just battle to live up to it, and everybody wants to beat you because you are the champions. But this, I'm afraid to say, could very well be it, as you mentioned, for them now. Their season very close to over. And that for the champions is just, I would never have predicted that for Washington Spirit. They just seemed too good a side.
Sinclair and Weaver, the difference makers right now for Portland. Washington trying to get back on the board. Rodman has a good lead ahead. Feist to the middle. Hatch almost slips through, but a better result as a corner incoming.
That's a good tackle from Kelly Hubley. She had to get that 100% right. If she didn't, it would have been almost certain penalty. Great defending. Creates the goal at the one end with that lovely volley off the crossbar that Christine Sinclair pounced on and then saves the day at the other end.
Off the set piece, can the Spirit tie it? Bailey, right in front, it's up and over. If the last Portland goal stands as the game winner, it'll be the second latest in the NWSL this season, coming in the 92nd. Still some time to run, though.
And if this result holds, it'll be the sixth game they've played. Have a look here. Oh, the goalkeeper doesn't get it again. That's twice from a corner. One for the goal that was scored. She got herself in a tangle. Doesn't win that one.
And again, it was a misdirected header from Hatch.
So close. Something for Bella Bixby to work on those corners. Other than that, she made some fantastic saves. This is the sixth game at Segra Field this season, and if this result holds, it'll be two draws and four losses. I don't think Chris Waugh is going to want to bring his players back here again if he can help it.
Well, this season he won't have to. And certainly, if Washington can't emerge with points out of this game, certainly won't be happening in 2022, period. Sugita. With the inability to chase it, Weaver opts to set the home side back a little bit.
Rhian Wilkinson, what a fantastic season they are having, Portland Thorns, under her guidance.
Sinclair finds Weaver.
Doing the professional thing, just working the clock down. Don't need to score again. That's it. They've got the corner, which was the intention. Well done, Morgan Weaver. She's come on. She's brought energy. She's scored a fantastic goal. She's made it all happen. And that's the strength and depth they have. Of course, they've got the youngster Moultrie, who's away with the U20s, is it?
Yep.
So there's another wonderful talent, besides the fact that Sophia Smith isn't starting. So again, strength in depth for Portland Thorns, and nothing but blue sky ahead for them.
Weaver has been the bench bullet for the Portland Thorns these last few matches. A little bit of a misplay gives it back to Washington. One last gasp to snatch a point from the jaws of defeat.
I guess Chris Ward will say, well, with 10 minutes to go, we need to hold on to victories. We need to hold on to the 3 points, and we couldn't. Couldn't even hold on to a point. That'll be disappointing for the coach and the players. Players also feel that, you know, when you're ahead with 10 minutes to go, you've got to work the clock down.
Rodman gets a step against Cuenca. Rodman gets stood up.
Bella Bixby. Yes, you can blame her for the goal, but other than that, the Portland Thorns keeper has been absolutely fantastic. She's through Rodman, a wonderful pace she's got. Could she have bent it around the keeper? Difficult to say. She had defenders coming in at her from every angle.
Quickly into the box, and a foul against Washington gives it to Portland.
Bella Bixby, though, one save after another, and I'm sure the fact that you win 2-1, everyone forgets about the own goal, which is good for the keeper. You don't want that to be a 1-0 result and everyone points to it. If you win 2-1, it can be forgotten because the rest of her play has been brilliant.
19 shots and 7 on target for Washington. Leads no offensive goals. And the one through on Bixby's accord is not enough. Christine Sinclair and Morgan Weaver with two late finishes escape with a 2-1 victory on the road.
Fantastic win from Portland Thorns. Disaster for Washington Spirit. One up with 10 minutes to go, and they can't get the 3 points or even 1 point. And you see the way they walked across to the goalkeeper, Bella Bixby, the defenders, even though she gave away the goal. A couple, more than a couple, 5 or 6 or 7 fantastic saves that kept Portland in the match.
The 3 points, massive for the Portland Thorns. They now sit 3 points atop of San Diego in the standings, both with 15 games played in the books. Still plenty of season to go, but certainly a good sign for the Thorns as they head into the home stretch following the ICC at Providence Park. So for Gary Bailey, our producer Gabe Sosa, and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Ross saying so long from Segra Field. One more time, the final score, Portland 2, Washington 1.